Hello, Mallards. It is Tuesday, and Megan and I have made the decision, it's just a decision, to do another Curious Correspondence Club today. But this time with libations, because we think it'll help. This is Chapter 7, Access Denied. And it's got some cool stuff in it, but mostly it has the card that was in the video, like in the end of the last video we watched, that is like hard plastic. And it's got this like little see-through portion.
I wonder if we need it for...
Which is kind of cool.
It would be kind of cool if we needed it for next month's 1-2. Like if there was a thing about keeping hold of it.
Yeah, that would be kind of neat. It's also got some red, like it's just got, these props are kind of interesting.
The props from the last one were also very promising, though.
Yeah, and we'll get into this.
Megan is doing her due diligence by reading all of this and giving us the cliff notes.
So, the first section is a "Here's what you missed on Glee," of "Here's what you missed on the video that we watched that usually doesn't matter, but I guess this time does." Mm-hmm. There's a van that the door swings open and it's full of vintage technology. There's a swiveling chair. There's a whole paragraph that describes this corkboard on the wall.
Nice.
Which claims to have a lot of red string, but I only see,
I assume,
like three pieces.
That we will be doing part of that.
I think that's our murder board red string. Mm-hmm. It's raining. Mm-hmm. And there's a jitter behind you. Oh. And the electronic labyrinth utters a prolonged screech.
And as then, electronics tend to do.
The van man steps towards a very old printer. He likes vintage technology. It's really cool.
So we've moved forward. We have now been put in charge of the computer and its firewalls, but luckily we have a, what did it say?
A little help from Gracie there.
This is Gracie.
You look down at the ID card as he stares back at you from his little plastic prison.
Look at him staring at you from his little plastic prison.
Those security protocols, there's always a way to trick them.
All right. Well, here we go.
Well, good news. We've started to sort of figure out some stuff here. We did find numbers in codes in things, right, Megan?
I guess.
We have not figured out this whole cash system at the bottom or a lot of other things, but here we are.
So we did the firewalls.
We did the firewalls, and those mostly sucked. I would say 3 out of 5 were terrible and 2 were okay. Mallory would probably say that 3 were okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because I had fun with 2 of them, and you had, well...
But they were also not in increasing difficulty level. I would say that the first one was the most tedious and annoying one.
Yes.
Do you agree?
I would agree with
and
that.
And I think that making your first one the hardest one, or the most tedious one, is a bad idea. So we were very frustrated for the beginning.
Yep.
And I worked on other things. And then we got to the point where Mallory mostly had finished them. We put the cork board together,
which
with
is
Danielle's advice of don't overthink it.
Yeah, that's true.
Because otherwise there was no way to know what order to put these in. But hopefully we've done it right.
We'll
Who
find
knows
out.
If we'll need it. We are doing better, I would say, objectively. But yeah. I have also read
every
single
hint. We also did the bank on the back. If we, you wanna show off the server bank?
Yeah. So I mean, the paper props for this one.
We did get the right answers for the server bank.
So we did that right?
Mm-hmm. And we figured out 3 of the 5 firewalls without really needing help.
Yeah, but we're checking the hints as we go because a lot of times the hints are just instructions. And we're also checking the solutions as we go because one wrong move and we're going to be frustrated at the end, which is always my problem with Curious Correspondence. And also, all of the hints... A lot of them are just directions
on like how to put this
together,
which seems ridiculous.
Shouldn't be a hint.
Yeah.
Like, if I'm asking for a hint, I don't want the hint to be put the push pins in. But we didn't get any hints or any directions for this cache data.
Yeah, which is a whole section.
We got two hints and a solution for how to put the push pins in.
Yeah, it doesn't make any sense. Anyway, moving on to the corkboard. We have connected the red string in order of words and stuff and came up with things that we think matter, but we thought they'd all be letters and they're not, so who knows what's happening there. Also, this should really be an actual string. This twine is very hard to pull through these pins and it pulls the pieces of the corkboard out, which is annoying.
Well, we did it. We finished it. Megan?
Mm-hmm.
Come back to me for a moment.
I refuse.
Yeah, so anyway, kind of a bust. We did eventually solve everything, though, and we'd only done one of them incorrectly. But it was a little frustrating. and for not much reward. But we're going to do another because we're gluttons for punishment, right, Meg?
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Are we going to do another one right now?
Perhaps.
I might make it two separate videos, though, you know, because I could use some video fodder.
The suspense!
So, we're gonna maybe play another one right now, and you will find out about it tomorrow. I'll see you then.